voice.
The earth is about to experience a generation of people who know who they are because they know who their God is. And our God is Yahweh, and He is the Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Beside Him there is no other. Without Him there is no victory, but with Him all things are possible. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Come on! You're an army dressed for battle. A thousand shall fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come nigh your dwelling. No weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. The battle is not mine, but the battle belongs to the Lord. Lift your voice, mighty ones. Lift your voice. How bad do you want to see America turn back to God?
Just for battle.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God bless y'all. God bless you. Welcome, welcome, welcome to another live broadcast of Kingdom Exousia International Radio. I'm your host tonight, Apostle L.A. Hill, coming to you live all the way from Temple, Texas. Amen. We thank God for each and every one of you for tuning in tonight. Amen. We're certainly glad to have you. Amen. I want to welcome some of our first-time listeners. Amen. If this is your first time listening, I'm telling you, you're in for a treat. Praise God. Amen. One of the things that we've been doing lately is we've been inviting guest speakers on, and I'm certainly honored to have our guest speaker on tonight. I'm going to bring her up in just a minute. Amen. But if you I'm not familiar with what we do, I encourage you, let me tell you, check out our ministry, y'all. See what we're doing. You can look at our website if you haven't already by going to www.kingdomexousia.org. Amen. We got some dynamic things that are happening in our ministry. I want to say that we're one of the best ones going on down here in the good old South. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. And the Lord is certainly moving by his spirit at Kingdom Exousia Ministries International. Amen. And not to mention, amen, this coming Saturday, let me tell y'all something. This coming Saturday, if you know somebody, if you're not even from Texas, but you really desire to be in this meeting, however, you know somebody that lives in the area, you don't want to miss our School of the Prophets. I've had the honor of teaching many men and women of God in the last 4 or 5 years. By way of online conferencing. Amen. We've had live trainings. We've done live streaming. We've done pretty much all of it. And I've had the awesome privilege of imparting it to many, many leaders. And we're going to be teaching our first annual School of the Prophets in San Antonio, Texas, this coming Saturday. And I'm telling you, it's an all-day event. We got 3 power-packed sessions. Y'all don't want to miss it. Our very own prophetess, Athena Solomon, is going to be opening up. Amen. And she's going to teach from one of the series that I've done in the past on the emerging prophetess. But I actually challenged her to really go a little bit deeper. Amen. So I'm excited about what God is doing in her life and how he's moving her along. Amen. And certainly she's an awesome woman of God. So y'all don't want to miss that as she opens up. And then I'm going to come back in the next 2 sessions. Amen. And we just going to go into word. And there's going to be some powerful revelation coming forth regarding the prophetic offices. Amen. I'll even be discussing how apostles and prophets flow together in those particular classes. And so you don't want to miss this training. We're going to do our best to stream live that evening. And for those that are out of town and can't make it, so that you can view it online. Amen. But I can't make no promises. We're going to do our best. Otherwise, we want to encourage you to get to San Antonio. It is worth the trip. Amen. Especially if you're within a 6 or 8 hour radius, get to San Antonio, y'all. Get there, come and hang out with us. Stay tonight and spend some time with us for our Sunday morning services. We start services at 11 a.m. with Sunday school, and then we go right into our Kingdom Fellowship at 12 o'clock. I'm going to continue with our series on spiritual warfare. I'm going to actually kind of piggyback off of the School of the Prophets, even into our services on Sunday with spiritual warfare in regards to spiritual portals and so on and so forth. And I'm going to tell you, the folks at Kimmy know we've been teaching on this series. They'll tell you this is probably one of the most dynamic series I've had the honor to preach as well. Amen. And we've talked about so many different things as far as the fall and Lucifer and so on and so forth. Amen. We've got the children involved. It's some dynamic things that's happening here at Kingdom Exousia, y'all. So I definitely want to encourage y'all to come on out and fellowship with us this weekend. Amen. And if you need any information, you can always contact our ministry at 1-800-724-0245. Again, that's 1-800-724-0245. You can also contact us for prayer on that line, too. We got many prayer warriors or ambassadors on standby that can pray for you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. This coming Friday night, y'all, don't miss. Also, we got Prophetess Athena, amen, with her Kingdom Voices broadcast. Amen. We just, y'all know, we used to be Kingdom Voices every Sunday when we broadcast on Blog Talk. Amen. And we met this past Sunday. I said, you know what? We still got that name, Kingdom Voices. Why don't y'all go ahead and take it? Amen. And use it on Friday nights. Amen. They've been having some dynamic talk shows, y'all. These three women of God, along with Prophetess Athena, amen, we got the sister Evangelist Latasha Rodriguez and Prophetess Renisha Murillo. Amen. I'm telling you, they come with some hot topics. The View ain't got nothing on Kingdom Voices, y'all. Come on, somebody say amen to that. Hallelujah. Amen. Oprah Winfrey and her panel ain't got nothing on these women of God. And I'm telling y'all, y'all need to chime in on Friday nights. Amen. And whatever y'all do to get your chill out time. Amen. It's not just girls talk. Amen. But they talking for regarding the Kingdom of God and some of the areas in which we need to grow and mature as far as our relationship with the Father is concerned. Hallelujah. So I'm excited tonight, y'all. We got a dynamic broadcast ahead of us on tonight. I want to encourage you, if you're listening by way of Facebook, if you want to call in tonight so you can just kind of touch bases with us, you can dial in tonight. Praise God at 218-548-7007. Again, that's 218-548-7007. And the passcode number is 76502. Amen. That's the same as the zip code right here in Temple, Texas. Praise God. That's 76502. You can chime in live. Amen. We'll keep the woman of God busy. Amen. And we also got a team of prophetic people on standby that will also jump in and help and minister as needed. Glory to God. So I'm excited, y'all. We got Pastor Sarah Grace all the way from Knoxville, Tennessee. Amen. We're going to bring her up in just a minute. I'm going to go into a quick song. Amen. And come back and introduce the woman of God. Amen. But I definitely want to encourage y'all this evening. Get on the horn, y'all. Call somebody. Let them know, hey, Kingdom Exousia International Radio is live and in effect tonight. Amen. If you want to call in, y'all know the number. Amen. Tweet somebody. Put it on your Facebook. Go across the hall. Knock on your neighbor's door. Run next door and pound on the garage. Hey, tune in. Come on, y'all. Check it out. Come on and sit by us and let's hear what the word of the Lord is tonight concerning what God has to say to us. Amen. I'm believing God for a move tonight. Glory to God. Amen. Real quick song tonight, y'all, and we're going to go right into it. Glory to God.
And the earth sing, you're exalted as your praises ring, cause you live in our praises, and Lord, you deserve it all. Lord, your love is everlasting, and your mercy is new with the rising sun. So as your children we rejoice as you give us life through your rising sun. Turn my back on living to praise. Even if I slip, Lord, I'm covered. sudden grace. Your mercy keeps me going as I'm seeking your face. So I'm singing hallelujah, I give you high praise. Humbling myself before you, Lord, I bow down. Giving you the glory with my face to the ground. Looking for your coming, if you need him, come now. Lord, we lift your name, no need for rocks to cry out. I don't need no rocks to cry out in my place. He's been too good even when I'm ungrateful. But he knows we need him, so he's always so faithful. So I open up my mouth to give him high praise.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Glory to God. Hey, man, I'm excited, y'all. Can't wait to get this broadcast started tonight. Praise God. Hey, man, we love it. Everybody just kind of pulled together in the last few hours, and hey, man, they got the buzz going, and we got an overwhelming response, and already the lines are filled up. Hey, man, I definitely want to encourage you again. If you're listening by way of Facebook, don't y'all hesitate to call in tonight. Amen. Request prayer. And you can always contact our ministry offline at 1-800-724-0245. You can also email us at info@kingdomexousia.org. That's Kingdom Exousia. And Exousia is spelled E-X-O-U-S-I-A. That's Greek for all power and authority. Glory to God. Amen. Without further ado, we're going to bring the woman of God up. Amen. We're going to let her come as the Lord will lead her. I'll let her go ahead and flow in prayer. Pastor Sarah, you got the floor. Feel free to flow in the Holy Ghost. Amen. We give you the authority to move as the Spirit of God will move in you. Amen. And speak prophetically and flow in the word of knowledge. You have complete freedom here. Glory to God. So without further ado, y'all, let me welcome Pastor Sarah Grace all the way from Knoxville, Tennessee. Praise God.
And I'm thanking God to reconnect us after all these years. That's yes. My safe days. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Social media is good for something, so I honor you and your beautiful wife. And I truly thank God. This is a Kingdom Connection. I know that the second I heard from you, I remembered you all, and then I went on your website, and man of God, just hearing just the sound that was coming out of that website and looking through the programs and things you all are there, I said, my God, this is Kingdom right here. This is apostolic prophetic, and I just leaped within myself. And so I thank God for you and your ministry. Amen. And your beautiful wife again, and I honor the presence of the Lord and what he's doing in you, and I count it a privilege. And tonight, I know that for the sake of time, I won't go on too long with introductions, but I want to jump right into what the Lord has given me. So I thank God for the liberty, because as I was preparing tonight, I heard so clearly beyond a shadow of a doubt that God had one phrase wanting me to release to your people, and that is this: there is power in your pressure. I know if we were in the church, everybody would probably just went, wow, there's power in your pressure. You know, we are in a time when there's such intense, extreme pressure on the saints of God, and even in the world, and even as the world goes, we're not exempt. Now, the Bible talks about how in the last days that gross darkness will cover the earth, but arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. But if anybody knows their word and knows the Bible, a lot of times glory is birthed through pressure. A lot of times glory is birthed through pain. And if I may, I would like to just go ahead and reference scripture. And those of you that might be listening in, I can read it to you if you have your word. Please open up and look at it. But I'm going to look at John chapter 2, and I want to release a little more detail about what the Lord wants his people to know on tonight. And I guess we'll see what happens from there. Amen. The wedding at Cana, starting at the first verse, the second chapter of John, it says, And the third day there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there, and both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus said unto him, and me, Jesus, they have no wine. Jesus saith unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee? Mine hour is not yet come. His mother saith unto the servants, whatsoever he saith unto you, do it. And there were set there 6 water pots of stone, after the manner of purifying of the Jews. In other words, they washed with it, containing 2 or 3 firkins apiece. Jesus said unto them, fill the water pots. And please keep in mind that these water pots were not drinking water. These were the water pots that were used to clean themselves before they ate. So fill the water pots with water, and they filled them up to the brim. And he saith unto them, draw out now, and bear unto the governor of the feast. And they bear it. When the ruler of the feast had tasted the water that was made to wine, and knew not whence it was, but the servants which drew the water knew. In other words, they didn't know where it came from. The governor of the feast called the bridegroom, and saith unto him, every man at the beginning does set forth good wine, and when men have well drunk, it is that which is worse. But thou hast kept the good wine until now. This is the beginning of the miracles that Jesus did in Cana of Galilee, and manifested forth his glory, and his disciples believed on him. If you go back and you start at the beginning of the scripture, the first thing I want to point out that is so powerful, I wish you had somebody to talk to, because I would tell them there's power in your pressure, is that Jesus himself, the Son of God, the Christ child, the one that was born King of Kings, the one that was born Lord of Lords, he did not want to do this thing. His mother had to put pressure on him. There was a need that activated the glory in his life. So I just want to take a moment and let somebody know tonight that your opposition and your problem is truly a catalyst for you to walk out the glory of God in your life, to be pressured into a position where God can move in your life. And you know, let me say this, because I feel the Spirit right here. A lot of people, man of God, a lot of men and women of God, apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, let's get off the pew for a minute. Let's go right to the pulpit.
Come on, that's
we
good.
Have struggles in our own life.
Oh, you're talking
good. We have
good.
Struggles. We have frustrations. We have all types of stuff. And the enemy will come, and he will tell you that you can no longer minister in that situation. You got to get it right. You got to be perfect and polished and all this and that and whatever before you can step to the pulpit and do what thus says the Lord. But I want to draw your attention back to those water pots. Those water pots, moving on from Mary, the mother of Jesus, pressuring him to step into his role, to push forth a miracle. Let's look at what he used. He used a pot, a vessel that was full of the dirt and the excrement. And who knows what that these people are walking on, that these people are touching, and they're washing themselves in this water. So he said, my God, he said, he didn't say go to the pretty river, go to the ninth well. He didn't send them to Jacob's well. He said, go get the dirty water pots and let me use them and fill them with wine. So one thing that we must understand as people of God in the kingdom of God is that even the scripture tells us not many noble are called. In Corinthians it says that not many wise are called. But God has called the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. So while you're using your issue, your frustration, your poverty, your depression, your obesity, your sickness, your disease, your divorce, your singleness, your abandonment, whatever it is that you think you're using to justify why you can't do it, God wants to let somebody know tonight there's power in your pressure, and I'm going to push you to be filled with the wine of my glory, of my Spirit in Jesus' name.
Wow,
and because
God.
We've got to stop discrediting what God has qualified, because God, again, uses the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. Mm. And we have got to get to a place in the body of Christ where we stop judging off man's scale. The Bible talks about how it is not proper for us to compare ourselves with ourselves. And when we do that, we find ourselves in a place of self-righteousness and ungodly justification. And we have to understand that in this hour, the world needs to see people that have survived some mess, survived some struggles, survived some strongholds. And I myself, my ministry started approximately 13 years ago without any preparation. I literally got saved about 6 weeks before my first speaking opportunity. I was just so glad to be saved. I just wanted to sit in the church. I didn't want to do anything except, you know, maybe just clean up afterwards. And my pastor came to me and said, Sarah, we want you to share your testimony. And I thought, oh my God, are you serious? You know what I've done? You know the background I come from. Here I am, just 20-something years old, you know, a new mom, a new wife, just young child, and my first child at that time. And they said, yeah, we want you to share your testimony. So right in the middle of my infancy of my Christianity, they called on me, and I got in front of that pulpit, and you better believe I cried so hard I couldn't see the people in front of me. I cried the entire time I spoke, and I was scared, and I was sick. I just thought I couldn't even make it, but God used He used the water pot that day. He filled his glory. He filled me with his glory. And people just began to cry and the deliverance took place. Just because I stood up and said, God can do it. God can deliver you. And at that point in time, my testimony was this. It was being delivered from, number one, being in the New Age movement where, you know, anything goes. You can do what you want to do because I did not grow up with the knowledge of Jesus Christ. And I came to the Lord in the midst of my first pregnancy when I was not married and I had a lot of drama going on around me. I was 19 years old and I didn't know anything, but I crawled on my knees and said, God, if you're real, show me who you are and I'll serve you. And it took about a year, but I came out of not only the situation I was in and ended up married and making my household whole in Jesus' name, getting delivered from drugs and alcohol, depression, you know, all types of disorders and frustrations. And so I stood in that pulpit and I testified. And I thank God, and you know, some of you might be all like, wow, that's great, wonderful, praise the Lord. But you know what? That is not really the greatest testimony I had. Because 7 years into my walk with God, 7 years into my walk with Jesus Christ, I found myself in a place I never thought I would be. Here I am married to that man. I've got six more children. I have a total of seven children. I've now birthed the church. I'm in the prime thus far of my ministry, traveling the country. I own a house in the suburbs. I have a church that just moved into the beautiful West Hills of Knoxville where no one thought I could go, starting from my living room as a female senior pastor in the Bible Belt with a multicultural church. And God moved so mightily in the middle. In the middle of my greatest hour came one of my darkest devastations. And about three years later, I'm trying to calculate the time that it declined, my marriage was over. And I ended up divorced, single mother of seven, lost my house in the suburbs, had to step away from my church, and thus entered into a tenth season of my life. And I thought that, you know, I had the greatest testimony because of what I came out of before I knew the Lord. But now I had to enter into a season where my name is branded as prophetess and pastor. Some even know me as apostle. And now my name also has divorce, shame, guilt, fear, you know, reputation. Everything is on the line. And when I tell you I thought I knew God before, I did not know him like I know him now. And I began to go through a pit season where everybody that was anybody minus two armor bearers that wouldn't leave my side and my seven children turned their backs on me and a few mentors that I thank God for. And I began to go into a season where all I was muck and mire and frustration. And it was like I couldn't see anything but sorrow around me. But in the middle of that, in the middle of that pressure, in the middle of that frustration, already thinking I knew God, already thinking that I walked in the anointing of God, I began to cry out for my pit. I began to cry out for my place of desperation, cry out for my place of pain, and I began to ask the Lord, you know, what, when, where, why, whatever you need for me, I'll do it. And as I began to pray, I began to see God's hand at work in a way I had never seen it before because I refused to let what everybody else said, what everybody said about my water pot, what was in my water pot, what was floating in my water pot, what it looked like on the outside, how much dirt was in it. I just began to say, God, turn this into wine. Do whatever you got to do. Take whatever I have left. Take my broken pieces. Put it back together. And as I begin to cry out, here I am, broke as a joke, sleeping on a couch. And I pray this will help somebody. Sleeping on a rented couch in a two-bedroom house in Baltimore, Maryland, where I could smell weed every night because of my neighbors. I had to actually endure hearing that one of my neighbors was murdered while I lived there, not in the house. They had stepped out for the evening. I had roaches. I had mice. And here I am, a woman of God. Here's the mighty prophet that was laying hands and prophesying just months before. And now in the middle of destitution, in the middle of a mess. And as I begin to cry out from that place, cry out on that rented couch where my seven kids are sleeping on deflatable air mattresses in the basement. They can't stay up for nothing. And I only let them sleep in the basement. For some reason, there was no mice down there. And I believed God to keep them. And here I am in my midst, still got a Facebook page up with my preaching pictures, nobody knowing what I'm going through, not even the leader that I sat up under knew how bad it was. No child support, couldn't get welfare. I mean, you want to talk about frustration. It was like every door was shut, and I praise God and worship God and give him all the glory anyway. And right in the middle of that, God first, the first thing God first was he rebirthed my praise. The second thing he birthed was my business. And I asked God, what am I supposed to do? I can't get help to save my life. And here these two armor bearers are, and they're going to get tired of taking care of me after a while. And I began to cry out and say, what do I have, God? What do I have? And I began to consider how I would make logos and websites for people. And I had tried to start a business three times before. 3 times before and it failed. And I said, well, I have no choice because I don't know how I'm going to feed my kids this week. So I stepped out one more time, sold a logo, got so excited, took my first week. The whole sum of that logo was $129, took it to the house and put it in my pastor's hands and sold it into his life, knowing I still didn't have money to eat.
Wow.
And sure enough, within the first month, my business spent hundreds and hundreds of dollars. I believe I had even a couple weeks where I had $800. And for a person who has nothing, that was something significant. So I just wanted to stop. I had no intention of testifying that, but I believe tonight somebody needs to understand what God can do in the middle of your mess.
Come on.
And now, as a single mother of 7 children, I have a business, Ingenuity Enterprise. Look it up on Facebook. And I have serviced former Miss Black USA. I have serviced authors. I have serviced just this week. I'm working on, I don't follow this one, but Ayana Van Zandt stylist logo just this week. I'm working on so many projects for prestigious and awesome people. But had I not took my pressure and turned it into praise and asked God to do something right up on significant with me, I wouldn't have made those connections. I've preached for clients. I've connected with clients, women of power, awesome women out of Dr. B.J. Rutherford and Psalmist and all these different people in Atlanta. I've served people in New York, Florida. I mean, all over the country. And God is yet moving. But that happened when I said, you know what? I'm just going to praise you right in the middle of it. So I just want to encourage somebody. That's like a quarter of my testimony. Not even the whole thing. And please don't let me leave this out. And now I'm in a 4-bedroom, 4.5 bath house. It's 2 years old. And when I got it, I didn't even have a job other than my graphic design. The favor of God is on my life in a way it never has been before. I allow my pain to turn into praise. And now it is my promise. And it's helping people walk in purpose. Being that I'm a graphic designer, a lot of times I do my own work and I have a Facebook timeline banner. I just took it down to replace it with something else. But it says this. It says, hard knocks open huge doors. Look inside your pain and find the power to embrace your purpose. And that is not just a cute little expression I put to get likes on Facebook. That is what I know for myself. And when I tell you that when God restored the ministry in my life for me to go back out and travel, when I had to get back in position, I had to go through some things, and I had to come to a place where I was willing to even come back to the city that I'm living in now that I had initially not wanted to be in because of the rejection and because of the pain of being here. And God has birthed, I tell you, the prophetic anointing, the healing anointing, even that apostolic creativity and networking. It is like never before. I truly feel like an olive that was crushed in the Garden of Gethsemane that is pouring out oil in a way I've never poured it out before. I still have moments that are hard. I'm still a single mother of 7. I'm still fighting the good fight of faith. But I tell you what, I have never experienced God's glory, God's presence, God's miracle working power. And it's
Hallelujah.
Every women on the line, whether you're a preacher or not. I am a single woman of God with no real support from the male figures in my life. And the Lord has shown himself to be a provider like none other. When I tell you the favor of God, I've literally had people call me and say, I'm going to give you $1,000, not knowing that I was in desperate need of it at that time.
When I see
God as a provider, my children's needs have been met. My family, even my armor bearer's needs have been met because they're still with me to this day. Moved to 2 different cities and came back here to start a new ministry with me. God is faithful. So I say all that to say that no matter where you are, what you're going through, if you are suffering in a marriage, if you are suffering from your own poor decisions, if you are suffering from the decisions of others, please trust me when I say that God can take that dirty water and he can pour it out and pour wine in that same vessel. God can turn, listen, as a matter of fact, let me be corrected. He never said that he poured out the water. He turned it in the pot.
Come on.
So he didn't take the water and pour it out. He turned it in the pot. I'm reminded of the scripture in the Old Testament where God says, I will make rivers in the wilderness. So a lot of us, we're trying to run from our wilderness, but we need to prophesy to our wilderness. Even consider the illustration of the dead bones. The bones were not collected and taken to the hospital. They weren't taken to the temple. My God, Jesus, they were not taken anywhere to be assembled back together. It was the word in the middle of the desert that was spoken over them and the word that was breathed over them. So right where you are, wherever you are, and whatever you are going through, open up your own mouth and begin to prophesy life, prophesy strength. prophesy breath to the bone. Prophesy water in the desert. Prophesy that water is now turning into wine. And see if God does not release a miracle. And then your testimony will be just like mine. And the only person that will get the glory is God and God alone. So again, I just want to encourage your opposition that's there to push you into the place you're called to be. Your pressure releases your manifestation. When what is inside of you is not coming out. Listen, some of you have been harvested. You went through a season where you are like that olive and you've been plucked from the tree. But being plucked from the tree is not good enough. That does not create oil. You have to be crushed. And even with an olive, a lot of people know the song that's going around by that beautiful young lady named Jacqueline Carr, Evangelist Jacqueline Carr, and it talks about the beating and the shaking and the pressing. We got to understand there is those three: beating, shaking, and pressing. So sometimes you got pressed once and you thought that was it. Then you got pressed the second time and you thought that was it. And then you got pressed one more time, but now the oil can flow. So understand that whatever is in you, God took you for a season and you thought you were finished in that season when you were just about to be harvested. So when you have potential in you that is not coming out, even like I'm sitting here, I'm actually at a restaurant right now over in the corner and I have a cup of tea with me. And this tea bag that I have in my tea would not have done anything had I put it in cold water. But the heat of the water that had to come out boiling hot, and then I had to, oh my God, the timing had to be right. And I didn't wait until the water had gotten cooler. I had to take the bag and throw it right in there at that moment, and immediately you see the color and you see the flavor becoming released in the water. So I say all that to say, brothers and sisters in God, that when God wants to get something out of you, he has mm-hmm. to create opposition around mm-hmm. you. So be encouraged tonight and know that there is power in your pressure. Amen, Apostle?
Yes, it is. Praise God. Hallelujah. Man, that was a sharp word right there already. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Listen, I'm going to let her give a chance to take a breath real quick, y'all. And we're going to come right back. And I heard you say you was in a restaurant, Pastor Sarah.
Yes, but I'm good. I'm over here hiding in the corner. They all look at me like, what's she talking about?
That's all right, because I'm telling you, you got a bunch of folks about to pull on you, and I'm pretty sure they're going to get blessed watching you get pulled on in a minute here. So we're going to go to a song and come right back, y'all. Y'all be prepared. And those that are listening by way of Facebook, look, this is your time to call in right now. Don't hesitate. Don't think about it. Stop shucking and jiving and come on and call in. Praise God. The phone number, 218-548-7007. Again, that's 218-548-7007. And the passcode number is 76502. You can get connected. You'll be live with us right here online. Glory to God. Amen. We're going to come right back in just a minute.
Your praise, I will worship shipping places. Your name has yet to be proclaimed.
God, we're going to go ahead and get back started up again. If you haven't had an opportunity to call in yet, you just now tuning in, you can contact the online live broadcast at 218-548-7007. Again, that's 218-548-7007. And the passcode number is 76502. Amen. We're going to begin opening up the lines and taking some prayer requests. Amen. If you have anything that you want to speak to the woman of God about on tonight, amen. Feel free to speak up. We just ask that you be respectful of one another. Don't talk over each other. Amen. And we're going to give you about 2 minutes. If I have to shut you down, I'm going to have to shut you down. Praise God. Amen. But we want to be able to get as many on as possible. And we do have the lines full tonight. So we thank God for all of you tuning in. Praise God. So the lines are open. Amen. We'll go ahead and take a first caller. Praise God. Don't everybody speak up at once. Hallelujah. They always act shy at first, Pastor Sarah. You're going to have to kind of bear with them.
No answers without questions. You got to ask questions to get answers.
Yeah, that's right. I can tell you what you just shared tonight, your testimony. I know that there's several. And one in particular just shared something with me tonight. I'd love for her to speak up. She's on the call tonight. Amen. And just ask for prayer, if anything else. But there's many of you that could kind of relate to what Pastor Sarah came from tonight. Amen. Don't y'all sit back and just, you know, just ponder whether or not you should say something. Just open up your mouth and let the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
I'll quickly request some prayer.
Come on, who's speaking?
Linda Jackson.
Come on, Linda.
I'm just asking for prayer. I just got a bit of news on day to day. So I'm just kind of getting a little discouraged. I've been church trying to keep my faith, but it's really been challenging.
Amen, Linda. Well, I want to agree with you, and I know that there's nothing too hard for God. And I'm not only going to pray and lift up a petition to God on your behalf with you, but I want to speak. And I believe that, you know, the Bible says that God spoke and the world became. And a lot of times we say, oh, he's got the whole world in his hands. You know, we think of God as a creative being with his hands, but God creates with his words. So I know that there may be some things in your life right now that you probably would desire extreme life makeover. Amen. Where God could just demolish the things that are not conducive to you having the life that he wants you to have, and then erect those things that he wants. So I want to agree with you tonight, and I pray that your faith will be ignited and be activated. There is nothing too hard for God. And Linda, I want you to understand that God hears you when you pray. And I just speak to any demonic spirit that has functioned through people to belittle you or discourage you or make you feel that God does not hear your prayers, that you are not close to his heart, because the Bible says that he is close close to those that have a broken heart, and he saves such as have a contrite spirit. So when you feel crushed and you feel broken, believe me when I tell you that God is listening. He knows every petition, every detail, every number, every hair on your head is numbered. And I want you to be encouraged to know that he really loves you. He cares about you. He cares for your cares. You can cast all anxiety over him. And I just speak that joy would be resurrected in your life. And I just pray in Jesus' name that hopelessness would just be gone tonight. And Jesus, and every loss, hallelujah, God, every loss that you've experienced and everything that you have seen almost just vanished. Vanished, almost just in front of you, just vanished. I just think that God will resurrect. Oh my God, that he would resurrect something in its place. My God, you know what, woman of God, I don't know you, but I believe by my spirit, there's some things you're not going to get back in the same form, but God can do something new and different. So I release new and different in your life tonight, and I release my faith that God is going to bring in new, and he's going to bring in different. The people that were in your life, they carried you to where they could, but now it's time to pass the baton to somebody else. So tonight I release my faith in the name of Jesus that you would just anoint her with oil. God, just refresh her, renew her, God. Every creative gift, everything, oh God, that you have in her. God, I speak now that the pressure that has been outside of her now is cultivated. The power that's on the inside of her. Woman of God, I release the well that is in your spirit. I release the well, and I speak that you are now flowing forth, and the water is bursting out. I believe that there's been almost like a blocking. And you know what? It's almost like I can see your hands over your own belly holding it back. But I speak that those hands come off now. Let it go. There's so much in you. Your answer is in you. You're looking for things on the outside. And God says, look inside, daughter, because it is well with your soul. There is so much on the inside of you. So tonight, I agree in the name of Jesus that the well of God on the inside of you be released. And guess what, woman of God? Guess what's going to happen to you? You're not only going to drink, but you're going to begin to nourish others. In Jesus' name, do you believe God tonight?
Yes.
Amen. Come on, somebody give God glory tonight, because I know that he is meeting the need of his daughter. My God, he loves you so much. He loves you and he has your back.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wonderful.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus. Glory.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. Glory to your name.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah.
We created it so.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless you. Yeah.
Thank you, God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Anybody else that is requesting prayer for tonight? Praise God.
Yes, I was calling for prayer.
Who's speaking?
This is Reginald from Dallas.
God bless you, Reginald. How are you, sir?
It's going pretty good.
Man, yes, it's so good to hear your voice, man. So good to hear your voice.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Go ahead. The woman of God is listening.
Amen. Well, Reginald from Dallas?
Yes, ma'am.
Amen. Well, Reginald, tonight, I just come into agreement for God to do a work in you, Jesus, like never before. I release my faith tonight into your life, that he divinely orchestrates you to be connected with the right people. I release my faith for a network of people, a winning team of sorts to be assembled in your favor to help you to walk into whatever it is that God has for you in the next season of your life. I don't know you, but I discern it's almost like you've been running and running to see what the end will be. But there's a strength that needs to come back for this next lap. And so I'm releasing my faith. Hallelujah, God. That this next lap, that you're going to have some wind under your feet. That you're going to have some wind that you have never experienced before. This is not going to be a lap that you got to bend over and take a breath. My God, this is going to be a lap because of the winning team that God is going to assemble for you. And I pray that you can recognize who they are. That God is going to put just so many people that are praying for you. It's almost like it's going to be air under your feet. Jesus walked on water, but brother, I'm going to see you walking on air. And then as you begin to run and not be weary, and you begin to step out and do like you speak and run. run and do what God has called you to do. That as you run and you pick up what God has for you and you run, it's like a baton in your hand, as you run forward and you do what God is telling you to do. I don't care what it is, business, ministry, family, I don't know what it is. It's something that you got to run on and do, that people are going to start to see you running. And say, oh, heck no, if he can do it, I'm getting ready to run on with him. I'm getting ready to step in the race. And I promise you, man of God, that whatever it is that you have to do in this next season, do what thus says the Lord. Don't think twice when God speaks. Do not question him. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, if you acknowledge him, he's going to direct that path that you're going to run on. And man of God, you shall run and not be weary. You shall walk and not faint. And you're going to turn around as you are running and you are running. And when you turn around and you see the people that are following you while you run, you have no choice but to praise them. And then you're just going to praise them to the end of that race. Amen. And there's reward at the end of the race. So run, brother, run, and don't be weary. Run, run. That's all I hear the Lord is saying. Run, 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 and believe him that he is going to give you supernatural strength. So right now, if you would agree with me, I agree for the super to come on your natural in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And for you to be empowered to walk in the fulfillment of your destiny. Ears have not heard, eyes have not seen, but God is revealing some stuff even to you by the Spirit. Can I have it, God? Can I do it, God? And the answer is yes. Is there anything too hot for God? Anything? Is there any? What can he not restore? What can he not renew? What can he not revive? So that is my prayer for you tonight, man of God. Run and watch and see if God don't give you super on your natural and put people behind you running after you as you run after Christ. In Jesus' name, I pray. You receive that tonight?
Yes, I receive it. Glory
amen, amen. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God.
Glory God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all. Speak on
I'd like to get prayer.
Amen. Who's calling?
Marty in New Jersey.
God bless you, Marty. Praise God. Good to hear from you.
Good to hear your voice again as well.
Amen. You said Marty in New Jersey?
Yes.
Amen, woman of God. I thank God for you stepping out tonight to receive prayer, and I count it a privilege to pray with you. And I release my faith tonight. And of course, you know, if you have a specific thing you want me to pray for, I know I'm jumping on it. I pray that y'all will interrupt me and say what it is. But if you're tired, I'll just go on if the Lord leads. But I pray tonight for just a, how do I describe this, what I'm saying here tonight? I pray for trust. I pray for renewed trust in your life tonight. I pray that there will be such a deep-rooted, I know that I know that I know that I know trust in your heart tonight for God and what he is able to do. It's like I have this vision of you like kind of by a window and by a phone. And a window and a phone can represent looking out for something, waiting for something, watching for something. And I believe tonight that you can trust God with whatever you're waiting for, you're watching for, you're believing for. And I would just encourage you, come away from the window, come away from the phone, and just begin to sit before the throne. Don't worry about tomorrow, but the sufficient is the trouble of the day itself. I want to encourage you tonight to be strong and to know that whatever God has, whatever it is, whether it be a blessing you're looking for in your family, a blessing you're looking for in finances, a blessing you're looking for in ministry, whatever it is, God's got it, and he's got a perfect set time for it. Even as a cook, you know, I'm not big on baking, I'll be honest with you, but I know this, that when you bake a cake, and you put everything together, you got all the ingredients. That's great, but if you stick your finger in that cake and you try to eat it, you know, it's not gonna, it might be fun, you know, eating the batter, but it's not the cake. So when God has something for you, he will begin to give you all the ingredients. Then, this is how you know you're getting ready to get something. It gets stirred up. Everything gets stirred up. Things are stirred up. And then you have to pour it into the proper dish. That's when you have it in the place that it's going to settle. And then you stick it in the oven, and then you got to walk away. And when you walk away and you let that cake rise, and then you got to be so careful that you don't open the oven at the wrong time, because what's going to happen, that cake's going to go flat. It's not going to be what it was intended to be. So be still, be patient, and trust God. He's got got you in the palm of his hand, and some things might feel like they're belaboring and they're taking a long time and they're not coming in the time that they were expected. And sometimes, you know, when we have delay, we do think it's denial. But I believe, God, tonight that he's got something very specific that he's going to bring to you that might seem like it's never coming. But God, just step away from the window, step away from the phone, and just lay at my feet, lay at my throne. And when you least expect it, it will knock right on your door in the name of Jesus. So I release my faith tonight for trust and hope and excitement and thanksgiving and worship and praise to just explode in your heart and explode in your spirit, that you can stand firm and know and smile and be full of joy, knowing that what God has for me is for me. Even when people begin to call you on the phone and say, hey, how's it going? What's going on? You just say, my God, it is well with my soul. God is my blessing. With my name on it. And Jesus, say, do you receive that on tonight?
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I didn't hear you say you received that, Marty. Did you receive that?
I said yes. Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Who was that speaking?
Josiah. I'm in Illinois.
This is who again?
Josiah from Illinois.
Cassandra from Illinois. I'm sorry, did somebody else catch it? Because it's a lot of movement going on.
God bless you, Apostle Hill. Apostle Hill, this is Pastor Dawson. Josiah, one of my members, Illinois.
Oh, okay. Wow, God bless you, Pastor Dawson. Okay.
God bless you.
Hi. Is it Ida from Illinois?
Josiah.
Josiah, okay.
That's right, Apostle.
Hallelujah. Come on, Josiah, what's your prayer request?
I want to do a prayer for my family.
For your family?
Yeah, it's like a lot of things just didn't happen one after another.
Okay. I missed that last part. Could you hear Pastor Sarah?
Did you say family?
Yeah, like my mom took us. But mom's cousin just lost his job, and then there's like other stuff that's been happening right after another.
Amen. You said something about your mom's husband?
Yeah.
Okay, well, we might not be able to hear the details too just because of the phone lines, but I can definitely agree with you tonight that God began to do a work in your family, and that comfort and strength and even strategy will come to your family on how to bind together and how to pray together. Truly, if two or more are gathered in his name, he is there in the midst. So I pray that there be a coming together in your family for prayer, and that you will ignite the power that's resident within your own family to pray for one another. And even you, I pray that you would just be excited and be encouraged to know that your prayers make a difference. And even I believe I heard that your pastor spoke up on the line, so we know that you have people that you can stand with and pray with. So I encourage you, even as I pray for you, that the prayer warrior comes out of you,
yes,
that you can fight and war and speak and decree and declare and do what God says. You know, there's that expression in the work field that if you teach, if you feed a man fish, he'll eat for a day. You teach him how to fish, he'll eat for a lifetime. So I pray tonight, in the name of Jesus, that you would be ignited as a prayer warrior, that you would have faith and confidence in knowing that even if you just mutter a few words to the Lord, that your prayers make a difference. And so I release my faith tonight, and I do agree with you for your family, for your mother, for her husband, for everyone to come together, for any drama to cease and release. And I release my faith tonight that which is not finished in this hour and this night, that you would take on the burden of prayer, and that you would begin to just mount up on that place of watching over the family and praying. And when you see things, I want to encourage you, don't pray from a place of fear. Sometimes we pray from fear and we don't even realize it. We're almost begging God. But pray from a place of faith, where you know what you're praying shall come to pass. In Jesus' name, do you agree with that?
Yes.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. It is well. It is so.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello, my name is Tierra from Virginia Beach.
God bless you, Tierra. How are you?
Hi, I'm great.
Praise God. What's your prayer request?
I have a question.
Go ahead.
And a prayer request.
Amen. A woman of God is listening. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Okay, so my question is, I know that you said that you went through a lot in regards to people turning their backs on you in the midst of your divorce and transitioning to Maryland. I just want to know, what scriptures did you hold on to in the midst of that darkness? I know that you said you had your prayer team, like a couple of armor bearers and your children. What specific scriptures did you hold on to?
Oh, my God, what a great question, first of all. And there were several. And one of the most important ones that I cleave to, and I don't have the reference in front of me, but the scriptures talk about whatever you have left for the sake of the gospel. Because even though I'm saying that people abandoned me, there was also, you know, leaving on my behalf, because the reason why a lot of them abandoned me was because of my beliefs and because of my decisions. So, and I believe that all of my decisions and my beliefs of what I had to go through, even my divorce, because it was biblical, it was for the sake of the will of God. So I held on to the scripture that says that whatever I leave, if you forsake, you know, houses, if you forsake land, if you forsake anything for the sake of the gospel, for the sake of your purpose and destiny, that you will receive a hundredfold in this life and a life to come. That was fun. So I believed that God was going to restore. Many people would come back and affirm to me that even everything I lost would be restored. So really in the midnight hour, when I felt like all hope was lost, that I would never have a home again, I never have a husband again, I never have my ministry again, I held on to that. I also held on to Romans 8:28, in all things, God works together for the good of them that love him and are the called according to his purpose. And I had to, you know what, I didn't just say it once and think it. I had to say it to myself over and over again. When the Bible talks about meditating on scripture, it doesn't mean just thinking about it. It actually means speaking it over and over and over and over again. So I had to take it almost like, I guess, the person would take antidepressants or something. I had to keep taking the word. And even when I didn't feel it, I said it till I spoke, you know, I spoke it till I felt it. So I had to speak it into myself. Another scripture, and oh my God, let me not leave this one out. Isaiah 54, it talks about the same old barren woman, you who bear no fruit. Of course, I have 7 children, so I'm fruitful in the natural. But it goes on to talk about this woman who has nothing, and she's in the middle of dryness. And it talks about how God told her to stretch out her tent and lengthen her cords, because she'll expand to the right and to the left. So God told me through that scripture, I can birth something beautiful through of your pain. And it also goes on to say, the Lord your maker is your husband. Because to be honest with everyone that's listening, the greatest pain was not that mom and daddy weren't necessarily right there at that moment in time. And some of them might have tried to be, but they couldn't see what they needed to be for me in an hour. No one could. But my husband, that's the greatest pain for a woman, when you no longer have that person holding, even if it's a negative relationship, when you don't have anyone to go to, anybody to talk to. So when I would begin to meditate on that, I would think of God as my husband. And some people say, oh, Jesus can't be your husband and this and that. He's a spirit. But you know what? I felt that God was my husband. He held me through the night. And I would just meditate on that over and over again. And finally, the last one I'll leave with you, and I'll put these on my Facebook or something so they can be copied when I get to my computer, because it's important that we can be able to go up and reference it. But when it talks about how God is close to the brokenhearted and he saves such that have a contrite spirit, and knowing that God was close to me, even if I couldn't see him, I would lay in the bed and I would say to God, because I speak to God directly and clearly. I don't echo spirits, but everything's not our style, though. I just said, God, I don't understand how you say you're close to me, but I can't see you. I can't touch you, but I know that you're here. And even when I would just say that to God, I could feel his presence. So those are some of the scriptures that help me. Oh, let me give you just one more. The scriptures say many, I believe Psalm 34, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them out of them all. And I said one more, but the scriptures are just so powerful. And I believe it's Isaiah 61, if I'm not mistaken, it talks about having double for your shame. So I've also meditated on that and believe in God that I will have double for all of my shame. So all those scriptures really indicate hope for a future and recovery in spite of loss. So I pray that encourages you and blesses you wherever you are in your stage of life, that you could cleave this some of those or find other ones. But what the most important thing I want to leave with you is make sure whatever scriptures you get, because, you know, promise books are wonderful when you can find those that speak directly to, you know, the situation that you're in and speak it over. You don't even have to feel it. You don't even have to believe it, because the more you say it, you will eventually feel it, believe it, conceive it, and see it manifest in your life. Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Praise God. Now, woman of God, you said you had a prayer request too.
I did. I was just hoping that I can maybe just get your prayers. I have been transitioned into leadership, like a more of a leadership role, and I have to stand in that. Like in the past, it was okay to kind of like stand behind and just be a part of, like, you know, the crowd, but like God is like rapidly elevating me, and I just want my gaze to be locked on the beauty of the holiness of the Lord. I just want my focus. I want to be led by Him, and sometimes it's difficult because I don't want to be a people pleaser, but I kind of have that gene. So if just need you to pray for me regarding that, I'd appreciate it.
Amen. Amen. So tonight, I just stand in agreement with you that you will be just fully confident in the Lord and His ability to lead and guide you, to say what He says, to do what He wants you to do, to be able to look past the desires of the people and the faces of the people into, like you said, the beauty of holiness and into God and His presence and His perfect will. And I just see a boldness and a strong persuasion to go beyond even conviction. And let me just say this in the middle of my prayer. Conviction is like when you believe something and you know, hey, I gotta do this, I gotta do that. But persuasion is when you are fully invested in what you believe. So I pray that God takes you, because conviction's not strong enough to stand up to people as I like to think it is. But persuasion is. So I pray tonight that you would be fully persuaded concerning the will of God in every situation, and that you, oh God, that God would give you, as the scripture says, the tongue of the learned, that you may know how to give a word in season, so that you know when to say what you need to say, because we do know that when you're in a position where you're submitting under leadership, that you need to know when to speak and when not to speak. So I pray that you would just have a sharp tongue, that you'll be wise as a serpent. Jen, I mean the sharp tongue meaning the word of God, that you would be wise as a serpent, gentle as a dove, and that you would look past the faces and hear only the voice of God, and that you would have such a sense, as the scripture says, that the Holy Spirit would say, this is the way, walk in it, and you will be confident. And I encourage you to meditate on scriptures that have to do with speaking the word of God and speaking out what God says, like Jeremiah and Jeremiah chapter 1 and Exodus chapter 4, where God speaks to Moses, and Moses was saying, you know, God, I don't want to say this, you know, let my brother, or let somebody else do it. And God rebuked him and said, who made man's mouth, the deaf, the mute, the seeing, or the blind? Have not I, now go, and I will be with you and in your mouth. So I encourage you to hear. I release my faith that you will be encouraged when you hear the voice of the Lord to speak what He says, to do what He says. And I speak it, and I declare it, and I speak the word boldness down into your heart. And it's boldness also carefully balanced with fruitfulness, that all the fruits of the Spirit are acting in your communication of the word of God and the ways of God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
You're welcome.
Amen. Tierra, I want to also encourage you too, real quickly. I just want to just jump in there and just I want you to understand that it's very necessary for you to really trust the Lord. There are going to be many occasions that are going to arise where the Lord will have you to step out on faith and to begin to mobilize in that gift and that calling that's upon your life. And you cannot be hesitant when God begins to speak. And there are even now many things that the Lord has put inside of you. It's almost like when you begin to learn how to flow in your craft, and you're very good at it, and you can almost begin to move in it on demand. Well, that same anointing is on you for ministry right now. And literally God wants to begin to upgrade you. And so it's going to be necessary for you to posture yourself around seasoned leaders that have the ability to impart into you and to equip you and to get you situated in a place where you're now able to flow in freedom and without any restrictions or any limitation. I'm telling you, I can just really sense the Spirit of God wanting to move in your life in such a way right now. There are so many testimonies that are wrapped up inside of you. And I understand Pastor John just told me that you was an awesome a psalmist. Amen. And I'm telling you, there is a grace on you to really flow in that prophetic through by way of song. When you begin to share your testimony, I mean, you just can't sing what everybody else is singing. You got to really flow out of your belly. The Bible says out of our belly shall flow rivers of living water. And that's how that anointing and that gift and that call is beginning to permeate in your life right now. And when you begin to sing as unto the Lord regarding your testimony, regarding your tests, your trials, what you're going through, I'm telling you, not only are you going to begin to set yourself free, but there are going to be many others around you that are going to feel the freedom of God like they've never felt before. Woman of God, God is raising you up for such a time as this. You are at a pivotal point in history right now as the church begins to evolve and begin to transition even into the next decade. There are going to be many that will call upon you because the anointing and the power that rest on you, even in the area of deliverance, I hear the Lord say. So be very attentive about what the Lord is speaking to you. Trust him. Allow. And a plan that the Holy Ghost has set just for you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And that is the word of the Lord for you tonight. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Glory to God. Amen. Anybody else on the line tonight? Amen. Want to request
prayer? Hello, Apostle Hill. This is Shamika from Newport News.
Come on, Shamika. What's your prayer request?
Yes, I just want prayer for increase in confidence. I also want to share with the pastor that her testimony definitely encouraged me, and it sounds very familiar as well. So I praise God for that that testimony and that awesome word that she brought forth. But I just want prayer for increase of confidence, and as women and I are transitioning into me, God is moving us to new areas as far as ministry. Just increase of direction, revelation, understanding, wisdom, knowledge, and confidence as well.
Amen. This is Tamika from Newport News.
Yes.
Amen. Well, Tamika, thank you for your good report of sharing that testimony. You know, it's a difficult one to share sometimes, but it's a blessing to know. And it encouraged you, and I do set myself in agreement with you tonight for increased confidence. You know that scriptures tell us God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound mind. And I just released my faith with you tonight that you have stepped out in faith to believe God. And I heard you say that you're leading you to new areas, so I congratulate you that you've been willing to go into those new areas, and he that has begun a good work shall bring it to completion to the day of Jesus Christ. And I pray and I declare that confidence is rising up on the inside of you, that even that what God speaks to you in the midnight hour and when the quiet times, if there may not be many, but in the quiet times when you're with God, that you're able to hear his voice, that you don't question yourself. And I, it's like, I can even see you almost, you know, God is speaking something in your eyes. Up like, huh? You know, and I just believe God tonight that if he tells you that you won't be afraid, if he says go, oh, you'll go, if he says stay, you'll stay, but you will be confident because the Spirit of God on the inside of you is going to call the shots, and it's going to let you know whether the plan is safe or out. And I just encourage you in the name of Jesus to be led by your peace, and led not by your happiness, but by your peace, because happiness is based on circumstances. Peace is based on the power of God. And I also, I release my faith for those around you that have confidence in the God in you. I release my faith in Jesus' name that those that you share with, first of all, I encourage you to be careful who you share with, but those that you are sharing with, those that you are letting them know what God has deposited in your spirit, I pray that there be an awakening in their heart and their mind. See you and who you are today. We know that Jesus could not do many miracles among those that were familiar with him and saw him as what he was raised as in the neighborhood he was from and the vocation of his stepfather, being that of the carpenter's son. So I pray tonight that not only would you be confident and you be able to stand no matter who or what doesn't believe you, but I pray that schools around you begin
set off the gifts that are placed on the inside of you. See this confidence, you stand firm and you be strong. And I release my faith tonight. I speak that it is so. You are confident. You are a woman of God. You will do what God said. You will go where God told you to go. And now doors are opening up for you to step through. And you will, you might feel sometimes like barrels on your back. Oh my God. And be careful when circumstance do not create the evidence that God has spoken to you. Because when God said to people, pretty from Pharaoh, he trailed right on their back, and then they were ran up in front of the Red Sea. But if you ever find yourself in that place where you, God is speaking to you and you are confident and you stepped out and you did what God said, and all of a sudden Pharaoh's on your back and the Red Sea is in front of you, then just be encouraged to know that he is going to open it up, and you be confident because you're going to run across on dry ground in Jesus' name. Amen. Do you receive that tonight?
Yes, amen. I receive that.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise God. We actually still got plenty of time left. Amen. If there's anyone else, amen, feel free to speak up. We also are still taking calls. If you're listening by way of Facebook, you're welcome to contact us. The number's 218-548-7007. Again, it's 218-548-7007. Praise God. Pastor Sarah, if they want to sow into your ministry tonight, how can they sow?
Amen. Well, I will be honored to receive seed for our ministry. We are actually in a very, very opportune time in our ministry because we're in the midst of launching a media network. We are launching, you really have to go online and see, but it's livewithpower.us, like United States, livewithpowerallspelledout.us. And when you go on there and you see the great work that God has commissioned us to do, it's out of the box, it's unordinary, it's very much so a mobile ministry. We want to come to your city, those of you that are on the line, and we want to encourage you and empower you. And if you can sow a seed, you can go to our partner page. And you can also go to our contact page and release that seed. And I believe, God, that whatever you sow into our ministry, that it will come back a thousandfold because God has really commissioned us to do something extraordinary. You can also visit me personally on sarahsgrace.us. And there we have a separate website that's more catered into my life. And God is birthing some books out of me. One of them is due to be released in September, and it's called Broken Mirrors, where I share about what I learned about trying to find your value and the reflection of your relationships and the deliverance that God has brought me. So I'm believing God for sponsors to help us with that. And I'm actually preparing to lay down a single as well. So we're believing God for sponsors for both my personal ministry and also for our life empowerment ministry, where the website is livewithpower.us. So I thank you for that opportunity, Apostle, and I invite you all to check out those websites one more time. It's sarahsgrace.us, S-A-R-A-H-S-G-R-A-C-E, sarahsgrace.us, and livewithpower.us.
Amen. Amen. We're still taking prayer requests. Amen. Feel free to speak up.
Hello. My name is Tia, and I'm calling from the state of Washington. And I was just calling just for prayer.
Amen. Is it Tia from Washington?
Yes.
Amen. Well, God bless you, Tia, and I thank God that you had the boldness to step out and to receive prayer tonight. And is there anything specific that you desire prayer for?
Just pretty much everything, and just staying in the Word and, you know, building a relationship with God.
Amen. Amen. Well, Tia, first I want to encourage you to know that God knows the ache of your heart. He knows the area you were so bad to just get her, you know, like, I just got this area right. And he knows sometimes how difficult it can be in areas when we're trying to just really get on the horse and ride it out and do what God has called us to do. So just be encouraged to know that he loves you. He knows exactly what your strengths are. He knows the areas that you're weak. We all have them. And I just want to encourage you that he can fill every broken piece in your life. It is his will that we be sincere. And the word sincere actually comes from vocabulary that was associated with sculptures, because when people would go back in ancient times to go sell sculptures, that they would actually put heat on them. And when the heat came, then wax would melt out of the sculptures, letting them know that they had been damaged. But when God is in the picture, what he can do is he can make you so strong and so solid and so just full of his presence that when he comes on, you never melt down. So my prayer for you tonight is that you will be so strong and so sincere, solid, and that when he comes on your life, that it can't do anything but expose the beauty of what God has placed on the inside of you. I want to encourage you to just really be conscious of your environment and just to be sure to fill your environment with positive things, because you, as a woman of God, is what God has called you to be. You are like a fish, and when you're in the ocean, you're in the water, you have everything that you need. But when you get up out that water and you get on a beach and you get in the wrong environment, baby girl, you will start gasping for air, and then you'll think it's something wrong with you. But in fact, it's something wrong with your environment. So tonight I pray that God just gently ease you right back in the water and get you in that proper environment. Fill your atmosphere with praise. Fill your atmosphere with worship. And I just want to encourage you. I feel this is very specific. Like, even, you know, just cut out, you know, sometimes you got to cut the TV, you got to cut the radio off and just begin to worship. And I believe, oh my God, I believe God is calling you into a place of praise and worship. Just, you know, pardon the expression, but making love to him, lifting up your voice to him. And when you do that, my God, he's going to turn some stuff around in your life. He's going to shift some things in your favor. He's going to turn you away from the wrong things and right into the right things. He's got it. Oh my God, Jesus. He really desires to pull you someplace very close to him, because he has something very specific for you, very specific for you. And I see that there's an anointing on your life and a call on your life that wrong people are attracted to, too, because they want to see if they can sabotage the oil that is in you. So I just want to encourage you, stay in the ocean, if you understand what I'm saying. Stay in the water. Stay filled up with God's presence. And I don't know if you have a fellowship or a place that you worship, but just make sure that every opportunity you have to worship and to praise and to open your mouth, that you do it, my God, because I believe that even in through that, he's going to fill you with what you need to be able to swim and do what God has called you to do. And this may sound really silly, but I have 7 kids, so you never know where I'm going to get my illustrations from. But I've watched a movie called Finding Nemo, and I believe that they were trying to, you know, swim, and they were trying to get where they had to get, and it was becoming difficult, and they were fighting against the tide. And I think the little fish said, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming. So I want to encourage you, woman of God, get in the water and keep swimming, and you will make it to where God has asked you to make it to. I hope that made sense to you. Amen. So that is my prayer for you. Jesus said.
I totally received that. Thank you so much.
Amen. To God be the glory.
Praise God. That's awesome. Praise God. Amen. Come on, y'all. Speak up. Speak up while we got time. Praise God.
Hello.
I bless you. Who's speaking?
Taurus from New York.
Taurus, come on, man. What's your prayer request?
I want prayer for more power. Increase the anointing God put on my life.
Hey, man, I didn't hear your name. Say it again.
Taurus.
Taurus? Amen. Well, my brother from New York tonight.
Taurus.
It's Taurus.
Taurus?
Taurus, like the car. Taurus.
Okay. Amen. Amen. Well, we speak that just like the car, that you are going places. Amen. We release our faith that just as you have prayed and you have requested prayer for power, I pray that God fills you up with his power and send you forth in the direction that he has called you to go. I'm going to encourage you to be careful. This is a woman of God I was just sharing with, to make sure that you recognize who you are and what you can accept in your life and what you cannot accept. Because even as you just said, your name is like the car. Something just quickened in my spirit. And when you consider vehicles, when you are a Porsche or you are a, you know, I don't know, whatever a nice car is, and, I'm not a car person, but you know, I like trucks, so I like SUVs. So, you know, if you're like a Cadillac truck or a Escalade or something like that, you can be fully potent and have all types of opportunity resident in that car. But if you don't have gas in it and you don't have everything, all the oils and everything that you need, that car is not going anywhere. So I just speak to you tonight in Jesus' name that you are like a fully loaded SUV or a fully loaded sports car or a fully loaded car. And it's your season and it's your time to consult the manual so you can get that horsepower that you need to go where God is calling you to go. And I want to encourage you that there are a lot lot of areas that God wants to just shape you in and polish you in, because it's necessary to your destiny. So keep crying out for that power. Keep crying out for the wisdom. And I want to encourage you tonight that the power is going to be in prayer and praise and the word of God. Shut out anybody and everybody that wants to bring a charge against God's elect and not to believe in what God has called you to do. I encourage you to go forth in every area of your life and do not sit on any ideas in this season. Whatever ideas that God gives you that he downloads into your spirit, the word of God says that he gives you power to get wealth. And he doesn't just give you wealth. He gives you the power to get wealth. So even tonight, I pray for the power in your life to be activated to get wealth. I pray for strategy and for clarity, for you to know whatever God is calling you to do and for him to put together, as the man of God I spoke to earlier, that winning team that you need to get, oh my God, like when you're on a race car track. And, you know, when I've seen it a few times on television where the car will race and race and race and then it will stop. All of a sudden, people just stop coming from the right and the left and they're gassing it up and they're fixing it and they're touching everything and they're making sure everything's in order. And then that person gets right back on the road. So I want to encourage you that your power is going to come when you get that team in order and that you get those people in your life that know how to help you get where you got to be. My God, and I pray that you really, if you don't already, that God will give you some strong mentors that can be like, hey, man of God, this is what you got to do. This is what you can't do, and trust them, because if you let them coach you, you are going somewhere and somewhere great. So tonight in Jesus' name, I release my faith for access to 1-8 power to be a witness, because in everything that God is going to have you to do, it's going to give him glory if you go forward and you do it. Oh God, and then when you are in that car and you are flowing in that power, watch who you let in the car, because one wrong passenger can sabotage your power, and I feel that so strong in my spirit. Oh my God, I pray tonight that any affiliations or ties that would try to hold you back from what God said, or try to jump in your ride when you're headed towards your destiny but sabotage it, they will flatten your tires in the spirit in Jesus' name. I pray that God would just sabotage anybody that would try to sabotage you. That is my prayer for you tonight. Be empowered, be full of God's grace, be full of his wisdom, be full of his anointing, and go forth and do what thus says the Lord. I agree for that tonight in Jesus' name. Do you receive that?
Amen. I receive it in Jesus' name. God, bless you, that word with rich power.
Amen. So God be the glory.
Praise God.
Amen.
God bless you, son.
God bless you, mama.
Bless you, woman of God.
God bless you.
I'm enjoying this. I've been listening to you guys ever since you came on. I'm really enjoying this.
Amen.
I would like to have prayer for boldness and concerning my health.
Amen. So you said boldness and concerning your health?
Uh-huh.
Amen. Amen.
More boldness.
Right. Mm-hmm. You really want that boldness. Amen. God's going to do it. God is going to do it. God is going to do it. So let's start with your body, because we want you to be healthy so you can be bold. So tonight I set myself in agreement, and I just release my faith right now that yoke-destroying power actually starts in your mind for the healing, that in the mind that peace will come in your mind. I release my faith. And let me say this, because one of my testimonies, and this is important, this is going to activate your faith, and we can finish the prayer. I'm a young woman of God, and I thank God. I'm in my 30s, but when I was about 31 or 2, I came down with multiple conditions in my body, and I had been very healthy. I'd already had 5 kids, and four kids, and I had gotten back to a size 8. I was strong. I looked young. People would laugh because they said, you do not look like you should have 4 kids, and blah, da, 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 da. And then when my marriage began to decline, and my frustrations, that was my frustration, but you can have frustration from work, from ministry, from family. But my frustrations in that hour, you know, that dark hour of my life came, I came down with multiple conditions. I came down with asthma, and asthma almost took me as a child, and it came back and visited me in my 30s. I came down with hypothyroidism, and even my doctor said that they didn't think I was old enough to even have that problem. And then I eczema came back, and I began to break out in rashes all over my body, like dry rashes. And embarrassing, but it's true. And God, you know, wants me to share testimony. And I got what was called a butterfly rash on my face, and they thought that I had lupus. So to this moment, I actually have like this spider web looking scar where they biopsied my arm, and they took a chunk of my arm. I went into the doctor just to ask for a little medicine, because I had broken out a little bit, and I just thought, you know, I've got like allergies or something, right? And then all all of a sudden the doctor looks at me. He looks at the rash on my face, which was very small, but it meant something to him. He leaves the room, comes back with the team. Next thing I know, they're cutting my arm. My daughter's sitting there watching this whole thing, and they're like, you know, Miss, that was my married name, Miss Branch. You know, we have to let you know that it looks like you have all the symptoms, you know, from our outward appearance that you could have lupus. And, you know, all this is just happening. And then I'm like, oh my God, here I am. I think I was starting with like my sixth child at that time because I had three in a row. And, you know, I'd gotten obese. I'd gotten up to 220 pounds with my seventh child, and I'm naturally about 120. And all of this at one time. And I looked in the mirror. I said, I can't believe this. Oh, my God, I can't believe what has happened to me. I'm too young to look like this. I'm too young to feel like this. You know, I'm getting the pulpit preaching. I can't even get out of bed. My oldest son, who was only maybe 11 at that time, had to take care of me because I couldn't even take care of myself. I had to ride the buggy at Walmart. Here I am in my 30s. And I didn't, even when I wasn't pregnant, I had to ride the buggy at Walmart. And it was like my body just declined. And somebody gave me a book called A More Excellent Way by Dr. Henry T. Wright. It's called A More Excellent Way by Dr. Henry T. Wright. And that book at first offended me because, you know, here I am still a pastor, a woman of God, preaching, laying hands, prophesying, but I was sick. And I was like, Naaman, I had some issues, even though I was a person of power. And I read the book, it offended me because it started dealing with emotions. Roots and spiritual roots to chronic illnesses. But after I wasn't getting any better, I finally went back and just got over it and just began to look at the book. And each one of my conditions related to something I'd experienced. And I'll just give you one example and then, you know, back into prayer and I'll finish the testimony up. And one of them was asthma. Asthma returned around the time that my marriage started to fall apart. And asthma, in this book by a medical doctor who is also a licensed minister, said that asthma, they say that it's, you know, dust and this and that and whatever, but psychologists are now arguing that it's fear of abandonment. So when I read that, I went, wow, because my asthma started when I was two and my parents broke up. And then when here I am getting ready to have a divorce and it's coming back. A hypothyroidism had to do with guilt and self-hatred. And I thought, I don't hate myself. I love myself, but I didn't realize that mommy guilt, that I wasn't giving the time to my kids that I thought they deserved, because here I have seven, you know, kids or six or seven. This was all a couple of years that I was going through this. Then, you know, I just couldn't give. My church wanted me. My husband at that time wanted me. The kids wanted me. I was a college student as well. I mean, I just couldn't make everybody happy. So I was actually, it was autoimmune. I started hurting myself on the inside, not knowing it. And the list goes on. So each condition had some type of spiritual and emotional root. And so as I began to address the condition, God healed me. And when I tell you I'm healed, if I showed you a picture of me 3 years ago and you saw my face, picture that you wouldn't believe it. You would not believe it. I am not on any medication. I am completely free. I have no asthma, no eczema, no hypothyroidism. I do not have lupus. I don't have anything. They did not diagnose me as definitely having it. They said I was like one trade off or something, but it was a very close call. I am healed. I am whole. I went from a size 18 to a size 12. And you know, that's a size 12, eat whatever I want. God has been good and restored me, and I look 10 years younger today than I did during that time. So I stop to interject that I don't just think that God is able. I don't even know whatever your condition is. If God can do all that for me, there is nothing that he can't do for you. And even one of my church members that I gave this book to had leukemia. And she was going through a lot of struggles. And this woman of God recently published pictures on Facebook of her baby girl that she just had when she went into remission, and she read that book too. So there is nothing that God can do. So number one, get the book. It's a great book. But number two, we believe God, that God starts with your mind, and he sends feelings of love and acceptance and just total peace and joy to your mind, to your heart, to your soul. And then as he nourishes your mind, your body is prospering. And it is in health, even as your soul is prospering. So I speak soul prosperity to you right now in the name of Jesus. And I release my faith that from the inside out, you are being recreated, healthy, strong. That God releases all natural spiritual weight, anything and everything weighs you down, and that you are uplifted and you are strong in the Lord and the power of his might, and you are
full of the power of God. And not only are you healed and whole, and there's a seed of healing started from the inside, look at it now, but it comes out of your hands, it's going to come out your mouth, and God is going to use you to speak healing, to release healing, to declare healing in His name, and even us, even as you get that healing, there's your boldness, woman of God, because you are going to stand up and say, I know what God can do. And as you stand up and you declare the word of God from your own testimony of what God has done, that boldness is going to come because you're going to say, I know in whom I have believed, and I know that He's able. So tonight, be bold, be courageous, and know that God has already started the work, and He's going to continue, and He's going to do it, and it's going to be like fire. You're going to go and ignite folks with boldness. Not only are you going to be bold, I feel this thing. It is just ending tonight with you.
Hallelujah.
Not only are you going to be bold, but your boldness is going to be so contagious. Young people are going to get it. Women are going to get it. Young women and men are going to get it.
Glory.
Oh, my God. God is
going
to to everybody around you, because they're going to be like, Mama, if you can't believe them, I can't believe them. I see young people getting set free all around you right now. I see teenagers and young adults getting set free all around you. I mean, they have the victory. I declare, I decree, God is ready to do it. I feel like jumping out this car. I feel this thing tonight with you.
Glory. Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Thank you, woman of God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, my God.
Thank Jesus.
My God. The God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. God,
I receive that, woman of God. Thank you, Jesus.
God, your word.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. Glory.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Glory.
My God.
Hallelujah.
My God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Yes, He is. Yes, He is. Thank you. Thank you, woman of God. Be blessed.
Amen. Amen. I receive the blessing.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God is in this place. Hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
I feel His presence. My God.
Hallelujah.
God, my God.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Oh, Jesus. Apostle, can I say something to you?
Yes. Yes.
My God, I respect your position of authority on this call, but something just came in my spirit so strong, and I just believe, guys, that some folks will bring some stuff back to you. Bring some stuff back to you, and tonight, I'm releasing my faith to some stuff. I don't know if it's natural stuff, if it's spiritual stuff, but I see some people turning around, and they set themselves in one direction, but God is going to block them like He blocked those people with that donkey, and the donkey going to prophesy, go home,
Hallelujah.
Go home and get what he needs to be given. You're going to see some people turning around and saying, I don't even know why I did it. I don't even know why I turned around. I don't even know what got into me. But they're going to bring some stuff back to you, and I declare that in your life.
Yeah.
Believe God, and He'll do a quick one.
Yes.
And you know what? Because you can be, I've kind of done both shit. Because you can be trusted with not beating them. You can be trusted with love and restoration and compassion, and at the same time walking in conviction.
Yes.
God, trust you with people, and my God, I see some people turning around.
My God,
back from the direction they set themselves in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah! I receive it. I receive it. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Glory.
My God. My God. Hallelujah. My God. Come on, y'all. Y'all, we still got a few more minutes here. We got about 20 more minutes remaining on the broadcast tonight. And we'll take a couple more prayer requests. So y'all come on and speak up.
Hey, my name is Marcus, and I'm just calling for restoration of my family.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, Marcus, God is able. God is able. Restoration in your family.
Thank you.
Father, my God. Father, tonight, I lift up this young man in the name of Jesus. I lift him up to you, oh God, and I lift up every person connected to him tonight. And Lord, I thank you that where even sin abounds, grace abounds so much more. And I ask you, oh God, to take any mess that's in the family and turn it into a message, a miracle, my God, and a ministry. I'm going to say that again. I pray tonight in the name of Jesus concerning his family, that there be any mess, just like those water pots we shared about earlier, that you would make it into a miracle, a message, and a ministry. And I thank you tonight, oh God. I even pray for him that you would restore his strength and restore his vitality and restore, oh God, everything that the enemy would try to take. And I thank you, God, that you specialize in resurrection, that when things look dead and look impossible, I thank you, God, that you will leave it until it stinks just so you can show your glory. So I pray tonight that the Lazarus situation in his family, that it would come forth from that dead place, that life would be imparted on tonight, oh God. Restore, God. And don't just restore the old, but God, resurrect the new tonight, oh God. I release him. I say, you can do it. You can turn hearts. You can change minds. My God, my God, my God. I release my faith, oh God, that you begin to bring it. And I just feel, even as I'm praying, that God is pulling and God is drawing. And now I speak to you that whatever you got to do to be in position for your part of whatever this is, that you be in position and you be properly stationed in your position. Do what you know you got to do. Don't do what you know you can't do. Just stand in position and stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Anything too hard for God? Is there anything too hard for God? So wait for it, anticipate it, and prepare for the restoration of your family, whatever that means to you. Make sure that, just like there's a movie, one of these Christian movies that came out, I think it's called Flywheel, and there's this man, and he's a coach, and his life is falling apart. His wife couldn't get pregnant. He had bills he couldn't pay, and then the football team was ready to fire him because he was a coach and he wasn't doing a good job, and he began to pray, and he began to pray, and he began to pray, and a man came into his office and began to encourage him, and then somehow they met in the hallway, and the coach was like, what do I need to do? And he said that there's two people praying for rain, and only one prepares. Who's really ready to receive it, or something to that effect. So basically, he said, if you're believing God for something, prepare in advance to receive it. Don't wait for the sign. Receive it. Elijah sent the servant out to say, I hear the sound of abundance of rain. Now go look for a cloud. And he began to prepare for rain. So I encourage you, prepare for rain. Position yourself. Prepare yourself. Embrace yourself with what God is going to do in your life. In Jesus' name, do you believe God?
Yes, God.
Amen, amen. To God be the glory. He is able. We agree. It is done. It is well. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Hey, Marcus. Amen. Marcus, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Washington State.
Amen. Praise amen. God. You're friends with Evangelist Latasha?
That's my mom.
Oh, okay. Well, praise God. All right. Amen. 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 Come on, y'all, speak up. Anybody else tonight?
Praise the Lord. This is Safina, Prophetess Safina. I just want to say that I was just truly blessed by your testimony on tonight. Me being a single mother myself and in a leadership position, you know, sometimes I wonder how it is I can do it. Amen. But just to hear your testimony, it definitely encouraged me. And so I thank God for that. I wanted to request prayer, amen, for the event that we have coming up on Saturday here in San Antonio that Apostle Hill was speaking of, the School of the Prophets. And so if you could please lift that up, that would be a blessing.
Amen. Well, thank you for your response and, you know, you be encouraged. And I thank God for those of us that are standing and with Jesus as our covering alone and knowing that, you know, God has our back. So you stay encouraged and stay strong and you keep doing with us as the Lord, because out of your ministry, many times will come that victory where God brings you into position, you know, to get what God has for you anyway. So, and I agree tonight for this School of the Prophets, my God, a place of activation, that God, you would move mightily. I thank you, God, for Apostle Hill, his family, and these women of God, this prophetess and his staff. And I release my faith tonight that you would bring everybody to that class. So right now, those that are spectating and speculating and they're really not participating. God, we start things that you're going to go and just begin to encourage them and even antagonize them if you got to get into that class. Well, oh, my God, even those that just won't accept the call on their life that needs to be there. Father, I release my faith that you just begin to shift those people into position to be there. And then I just thank you in advance that everything's prepared and that you are going to move mightily in that place. Mm-hmm. And I consider the scripture, it talks about how when all the pieces in the temple got in the right positions, how the glory fell. And so I pray that all the right people, because we're in the New Testament now and don't have temples built by man's hands, but by people in the spirit. And Father, I release my faith that you will put all the people in the right position so that the glory can fall. They can get in their position. And I release my faith for boldness. I pray that there be no fear and those who are instructing, that it would be just total boldness and trust, because this is a major task to try to teach the prophetic. Because it's not, it can only be taught by the unction of the Holy Spirit and proper, you know, understanding of the Word of God. And I pray, God, do it, Lord, in your name's sake. Do it for your name's sake. Activate the prophets. Let them go forth with power, God, and let it be a testimony, God, to true fivefold ministry and the power of being connected to the right covering and to the right leadership. God, I pray even through this class that you would add to the church and that you would begin to send people to be connected that need the training, that are hungering for it. So those that have not yet even heard of it, Lord, I pray that you would begin to draw. And I even pray that there be an expansion of this class, that it will be able to leave the area that it's in and go out and endeavor in other regions for your name's sake, God, for those that really need it, God. Let it be done in your name, I pray. In Jesus' name, do it, Lord. Amen.
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 Praise God. Praise God. Amen. Come on, we got about 12 minutes remaining, and y'all got a few more minutes to get your prayer request in. Praise God.
Hi, this is Rosa. Amen. This is Sister Donna from Corpus Christi, and I've been so blessed by what's going on. It's almost hard to just stop and ask for prayer. But I want to ask for prayer in my ministry and my everyday walk, just that I am just staying focused and on the right path that God has me on as far as doing what he says to do when he says to do it. Just moving in his timing and resting in him when I need to rest in him.
Amen. Amen. You said you're from Corpus Christi, Texas. What was your name again?
Donna.
Donna. Well, Donna, tonight, I just discerned, you know, that there's really a strength in you that's, it's almost like a, I don't know if this refers to natural or spiritual children, but it's just like a mother figure in you, but it's balanced with like a military figure in you, if that makes any sense. There's a strength and a compassion together, and I just release my faith that God would align you with those people that need that from you, that need that nurturing, yet protecting type of instinct. I just release my faith tonight in Jesus' name that you would have that strong walk with God. And I release my faith tonight that God would give you clarity on the things that you're supposed to do, and that you wouldn't doubt yourself, and that you would know that he has spoken, that he has spoken, and that you would, my God, that you would recognize that the little that you give God becomes much, even if it's, you know, 5 minutes of prayer, 15 minutes of prayer. I pray that he would multiply and that he would make it to a place where you feel like you had 4 hours when you might have only had 4 minutes, because God knows your heart is to be connected to him. Your heart is to trust him. And I believe that he's saying that he has found you faithful in seeking and searching. So I pray tonight in the name of Jesus that he would increase. Align you with the right people that you are called to encourage. You might not even feel qualified in some dimensions of the people that he'll bring into your life, but you know, God does not call the qualified, he qualifies the called. So as he calls you into that place of just being available, and it doesn't even always have to be anything real deep and real spiritual. Sometimes it's just going to lunch, or you know, just spending an extra 5 minutes in the parking lot talking to somebody, or taking them to an appointment or something like that. But I believe that God is going to let you become a placeholder, if that makes any sense, for some people that are waiting for more permanent relationships in their life and they need something that you have. So I just release my faith, God, that you do it, that you do it, that you make her laugh. because you just encourage her so that even out of her own pain, she's going to be able to have purpose. And the things that she's experienced are going to go into, my God, I feel like she's going to be able to look at you and say, now I understand. Now I understand why this or that or whatever, because somebody's going to get something. There's oil in your experiences. There's oil in what you've seen and experienced in your life. And God is going to let you begin to pour that oil on other people through relationships. So tonight, God, I release my faith that you do it. And, oh, God, and in the name of Jesus, I just release my faith to say you would just do something extra special in her finances. I release my faith, God, that you loosen, God, any grip of just anything that's a frustration. I mean, you just begin to release finances and things that people just begin to bless her, whether it be because she has a need or you just want her to know that you desire for her to be blessed. I release my faith that you just begin to expand freedom when it comes to finances and that there will be the ability to travel and do the things that you may have for her to do, even if it's just visit a family member or do something to get out of her local community. I just release my faith for finances to not be an issue with anything that you have called her to do. And I know that God is able to make all grace abound to you and grant favor to you even when finances are not necessary. Favor can open up doors. And I just release my faith that everything connected to her, that you are perfecting that which concerns her. I thank you for this woman of God. I thank you in advance for a great work that you're going to do in her. I thank you, God, that the worst is over and whatever she's experienced in her life, that her best is yet to come. I thank you, God, that every destructive plot of the devil to just bring distraction and keep busyness, that there's going to be such a peace that when the storm rages and the waters roll, that she's just going to walk on them waters. I thank you tonight, oh God, that you're doing it for your name's sake. And I thank you that through this, you're going to birth a radical praise out of her. I thank you, God, that a radical praise, one that might be even something that you never experienced on this level, that a radical praise is going to come up out of her belly. Yes, and that she's going to begin to give you glory and give you praise. And she's like, I don't even care what none of y'all think about me, because she's going to know that it was you and you alone that did the things that you're about to do in her life. Yeah. And I thank you for that boldness and that radicalness that's going to come on her life. And just as the other woman, God, it's going to ignite something in other people seeing her praise. Because even as Paul and Silas at midnight, when they begin to sing and praise God, jail got set and then folks got saved. So I release my faith for all of those things to be implemented in your life for the glory of God, for the name of Jesus. And just be sure to give him the glory for what he does in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sister Donna, you're going to be able to make it this weekend.
What's going on the weekend?
We got the School of the Prophets in San Antonio. You'll be able to make it?
To come to San Antonio or not? I don't think.
I'm sorry.
I can do over the phone or? No. Any other way participating?
No, it's gonna be live in San Antonio this weekend.
No, honestly, I don't have the finances right now.
Well, it don't cost nothing. All you gotta do is put some gas in the car. Come on. That's it.
Well, we speak money for gas in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
We release our
faith. Hallelujah.
I'll stay open. You never know what God's gonna do.
Amen. Amen. I'm gonna put this out there real quickly. You know, as many of y'all that are in the Texas area that's listening under the sound of our voices this evening, I'm just gonna challenge y'all. See, I'm gonna tell you right now, everybody running off to the Mega Mess. Oops, I'm sorry. Did I say Mega Mess? But everybody running off to the little thing going on up in Dallas. On this coming Saturday, I'm telling you, lives will change. If you got a ministry calling, if God called you to any capacity in regards to the prophetic, I don't care if you think all you're supposed to do is teach Sunday school. Amen. Let me tell you something. Our Sunday school teachers prophesy. See, ain't nobody going to say amen on that. Glory to God. And I'm telling you, we are going to challenge you in the prophetic. And before you leave on Saturday night, I guarantee you will be prophesying. And anybody that was in the last School of the Prophets that we just had, we had the Dominion Mandate back in May. We had Prophet Lopez to come in, and we had Apostle Steve Jackson and his wife. Amen. We had an awesome and dynamic time. And we're just going to kind of upgrade you a little bit in this next coming weekend. And we're going to release you in some of the greatest dynamics of the prophetic that you've not known. And this is the portion of our ministry that we refer to as progressive revelation. God is going to minister to many hearts, and there are going to be many that are going to be moving very strongly in the prophetic. I heard some of y'all request and ask for boldness tonight. I'm telling you, you're going to prophesy like a crazy woman. You're going to prophesy like a crazy man by the time you walk out of there. And there's just going to be a move of God, like I said. So I want to challenge y'all. Yo, find some seed money. We hold on. Let me tell you, we'll sow into McDonald's and Starbucks and Burger King, and we'll spend all types of money. We'll find a way to make it to the movies so we can go see The Butler and My Mandy. That was a good movie. Glory to God. And we'll find some kind of way to spend our money on something else. But when it comes to the kingdom, we hold a tight fist. Let me tell you something. Invest in your craft. If God has given you the ability to flow and to operate in ministry, sow some seed money. Come on, somebody say amen tonight. Come on. God loves a cheerful giver. And some of y'all need to find a reason to get happy when it comes to sowing some seed. See, some of y'all came in on the call at the last minute. See, Pastor, I can relate to you. I know what it's like to sow some money and then you ain't got your gas and your light on. Come on, somebody.
So when you
really stepping out on faith, some of us know what it means to give and you ain't got nothing to give. Oh my goodness.
Oh, yes, Lord.
So I'm gonna challenge y'all. Amen. Even tonight, for the woman of God, she gave her website out. Amen. Y'all need to sow. Some of y'all have been tremendously blessed. Go to her website, www.livewithpower.us. Amen. Go and sow a seed. Amen. Or you go to www.sarahgrace.us. Sow a seed, y'all. Stop holding on to what God gave you. If you working, if you got any kind of income coming in, you should be sowing regularly. Not sparingly, but regularly. Let me say that one more time for some of y'all that just got a GED. It's, don't sow sparingly, but regularly. Glory to God. Amen. We love y'all tonight. Amen. We're right about 11:28. Amen. We got a couple of minutes remaining. Pastor Grace, I'm telling you, we enjoyed you tonight. Amen. I'm talking, that was an awesome word from the Lord. Amen. Let me tell you, it was quick, but it was sweet. It cut. It maintained. It flowed. It did all the above. Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is certainly good. Amen. I'll tell y'all what. Y'all want to stay connected. Man, some of y'all that are really interested in ministries, I want y'all to check out our website. We do have a network fellowship that we're getting jumping off the ground. As a matter of fact, this coming November, or October 31st through November 3rd, we're looking to have our first annual Juicy Global Fellowship Conference where we bring in some of the churches that we cover and some of the network leaders that have been a part of our covering as well. Amen. We want to bring them in. We got some awesome speakers lined up. We may do some finagling there as far as our schedule is concerned, depending on the speaker's availability again. Amen. But we're looking to have an awesome time in the Lord. This coming October 31st through November 3rd. Get connected. If you really want to get situated with a group of people, amen, that's really about their Father's business, amen, we ain't finna give Oprah our platform. I'm sorry. See, I ain't gonna get no amens on that. Glory to God. We just not doing it. Amen. Only person gonna get the platform is the Holy Ghost and whoever is ready and willing to flow in the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. Praise God. So we just got some awesome things that's happening. If you want to get connected to some true kingdom leaders, amen, come and check us out. Amen. We'll send you some information. We'll get you a packet in the mail, and you can get acquainted to what God is doing with us. Amen. And again, you can visit our website at www.kingdomexusia.org, and you can find out what exactly we got going on. Amen. Take a look at our vision. You can take a look at our statement of beliefs. Amen. We certainly just believe God to do all that he said he was going to do with us. Amen. So come back, y'all, again next Wednesday night. We got another awesome, fantastic, special guest that's going to be with us, Prophet Lopez, all the way from Houston, Texas. Amen. He's going to be our special guest speaker on next Wednesday. Amen. And again, some of y'all already familiar with him. He's been on with us once before. Amen. And I'm telling you, that man of God, him and I have a kindred spirit, man. And I'm telling you, he and his team is going to come with a word that you're going to need to hear from the Lord. And that's on next Wednesday. Amen. So y'all, hey, we still moving. We still got momentum. Amen. We might get silent one Wednesday, but we're coming back the next. Amen. Glory to God.
Sarah Grace.
Sarah's Grace.
Sarah's Grace. It's Sarahs, like Sarah's, like it belongs to me. Sarahsgrace.us or livewithpower.us. Okay. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. And don't forget y'all, Kingdom Voices on Friday night. Amen. With Prophetess Athena and her team, Renisha Murillo and Latasha Rodriguez. Don't y'all miss that. Amen. They've been having some dynamic talk shows. I'm telling y'all, The View ain't got nothing on them. Hallelujah. Amen. Make me want to say, King Kong ain't got nothing on me. Hallelujah. Amen. So y'all got to check it out. Does some dynamic broadcasts. And I would even encourage you to go and check out what you missed in the archive. They already recorded, and they've just been having a wonderful time in the Lord. Amen. So Kingdom Exousia Ministries is on the roll, y'all. We mobilizing. We moving by the Spirit. Amen. And God is in control. We thank the Lord for it. Amen. So without that said, Pastor Sarah, if you don't mind, I will let you have some final words and just go ahead and release us in prayer. Amen. And we'll see you guys next time. Praise God.
Can I get a prayer before you hang up?
Who's speaking?
This is Rosa.
All right, Rosa. You know I'm be looking for you on Saturday, right?
Oh, yeah. I'll be there.
All right. Praise God. Now you get your praying, okay?
Yeah. I just wanted to, I think I'm leaving Sunday, actually, after the conference. I'll be going back to Wisconsin to be with my family, and I haven't seen them in a while, and I just need prayer.
Amen. Well, Rosa, I can set myself in agreement with you tonight that God will go ahead of you and he'll go with you, as the scriptures tell us that he will. And I just release my faith that, you know, if you haven't seen him in a while, there might be some anxiety there. So I just release my faith, no anxiety. And I just speak that the presence of God is with you and just bring comfort to you. I just release my faith for comfort in your life, strength in your life, traveling mercy, protection, covering. I release my faith that even as you are traveling, there's some things that you want God to speak to you about. And I'm releasing my faith that in your travels, you're going to get some answers for some things that you've been waiting on God for. So cut the radio off and just begin to listen to him to speak to you during your travel time. So I release my faith that he goes before you, he goes with you, he stands with you. And then I pray that as you go to see your family, that God will just bring comfort and that he would just bring just favor with you as you leave from wherever it is that you are, that you carry some of the grace that is imparted to you from where you are to where you're going. And that is my prayer for you tonight in the name of Jesus. Be encouraged, be strong, be empowered, and make sure that you continue to raise your petitions to God in prayer, in praise, and in worship every day, and watch and see if he doesn't turn some stuff around in your favor. And again, Apostle Hill, I thank God for the opportunity. It was truly a pleasure and a joy. I felt like I was in a revival tonight.
Amen.
I thank God for your listeners and how engaged they were. I know it might have been a little bit getting them started, but I thank God for those that stepped out for prayer, and each of you, you know, just such a special place in my heart as I begin to see the Lord and his concerns for each one of you. So I thank God for the opportunity. I truly count it as a privilege to be able to serve the Lord and to serve his people. So I thank God for what you're doing. I set myself in agreement, Apostle, that he continues the great work he's doing, and I look forward to seeing what God has for us to do to connect in the ministry with the great work that you're doing there. And tonight, Father, I just thank you for all the people that came together in your name. And I release my faith that each one of them, if they step away from the phone, they won't step away from your presence, and that they will carry the words that were spoken to them. Even if they listened in and did not receive a specific word, Lord, I even know that something in the atmosphere was imparted to them. I thank you again for this prayer call, and I pray that even next week you continue to go to higher heights and deeper depths and continue the great work you have started in this ministry. Let it all be done for your name's sake, so that the name of Jesus that is my prayer tonight, and I thank you, and I praise you, and I honor you. Now to the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, the honor and glory forever. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. We love you guys. We'll see you next time. Praise God.
Amen. God bless you. Good night. Good night.
I'm slaying. Rua, 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 rua. A shout of victory over the enemy. Rua, 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 rua. Jericho walls are falling and giants I'm slaying.
Rua, 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 rua. Jericho walls are falling, the giants are